Today on Vibe with Cherry, I got to chill with my girl, Jaida Maurian, aka the versatility queen. She does it all. She sings, raps, and dances. Her fan base is growing each and every day with 10.2K followers on Instagram and 14K views on her latest single, Make You Wanna Say. We chopped it up and hit on many great subjects, so this is something you just don't want to miss. Stay tuned. No.
Yeah, they wanna eat off my plate. They wanna eat off me. When I had my vision, you couldn't see it.
I'm off to better things. I'm only doing shit that's gonna make me elevate. Only one people around that's gonna
bitch,
make me better.
In that, it's so ooh, they ask how I get that ooh. I'm too busy getting this money, getting this cheddar.
What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Charity, and today I got a lovely guest, Miss Jaida. Y'all already know her off Instagram. She do everything. She sings, rap, dances. She got the body, yada yada. She got it all. Like, welcome to my show.
Thank you for having me.
How are you today?
I'm pretty good. How are you?
I'm doing good. I mean, we just had to move around just to get the perfect location, but we finally here. Like, how would you describe yourself?
I'm very energetic and outgoing.
You are a social butterfly.
I am.
Definitely. I am too. Definitely. I love talking to anybody. I could talk to anybody. Where are you from?
Everywhere but nowhere.
What does that mean?
I'm a military brat, military brat. So I moved around a lot of my life, but I claim Greenville as home now. Been here for about 7 years. Mm-hmm. So this is home, but I'm not really from anywhere.
So yeah. Do you like to travel?
I do.
What places have you been, and which one did you like the most?
I've lived in Ohio, New York, Tennessee, mm-hmm. here in Germany. Germany was definitely my favorite.
Germany, yes. Wow. Well, when I think of Germany, I think of chocolate. Have you ever ate any chocolate from Germany?
The best chocolate.
The best chocolate.
The food, the fries, everything. I love Germany, the culture. Mm-hmm. It was a lot of fun.
How old are you?
I'm 19.
You're 19? Mm-hmm. Wow. She do not seem 19. She done did so much. You're performing, you're making songs, you graduated high school fast. Like, what made you graduate early?
What made me graduate early was music. Like, mm-hmm. I decided that I wanted that free year, you know, where instead of just going straight into college after senior year, I wanted that gap year to really focus on myself, my brand, what I was trying to do with my life. I knew I did not want to go to college yet. Mm-hmm. That was my backup plan, but graduating early gave me the perspective to feel like I can really do this. And I started. That's when I really started to take music serious.
When you planned out like what you wanted to do. When I was in high school, I was just going with the flow.
Right.
Living life. But you seem like you already like knew what you wanted to do. Like, what motivated you to do that?
So my sophomore year, mm-hmm. I had went to Greenville High. So I was, you know, Tigers all the way, but I had went to Greenville to cheer my sophomore year. Mm-hmm. Something happened. I kind of went through like a little breakup or whatever, a little boy drama. Mm-hmm. And I ended up coming back to Southside because I just didn't want to be at Greenville anymore, you know, all that stuff. And I just didn't feel like I belonged there. When I went back to Southside for the remainder of that year, I kept finding myself rushing to do my work just so I could get on my phone, put my headphones in, and write songs in class. Like, I'd literally be in class. You know how, like, the teacher would be like, okay, put your headphones in. While kids were just listening to music, I was making my own. So sophomore year, I started realizing I started to neglect my work in a way where I was just taking it home and doing it. Mm-hmm. I was asking my teachers, hey, can I stay after school because I want to do this work that's for tomorrow so I can be in your class tomorrow just writing. And I was very straight up with the teachers. I was like, this is what I'm doing, you know? Like, mm-hmm. I would go sit in the hallway, like, and just write, like, when I'm done with all my work. So mm-hmm. that's what made me realize after sophomore year, this is what I wanted to do. Junior year, I walked in, I looked at my schedule, I said, I'm already taking mm-hmm. APs, I've already got the credit to graduate. I walked into the guidance counselor's office, didn't even go to first period. Fuck homeroom. I walked straight in there and I was just like, I'm graduating early, Mr. Westfield. And he was like, what? Mm-hmm. And I was like, yep, I'm graduating early. Give me the form. And I did it. And that was it. And the rest is history.
Wow, that is queen mentality, girl. Boss mentality. Like, it's 19, y'all. I wish I had the head on my shoulders that you had, because like, I was not focused on the future. You're sitting there finishing your work, and you got your work done. And wasn't like
got it done.
Me, I would, if it, I was in the same situation, I would have neglected my work and just, you know, ignored it. But you did both of them. How does academics play a role in your life?
So academics for me were always important. Mm-hmm. You know, that was the one thing that my parents made sure we knew was important. You know, at least get your high school diploma.
Yeah.
School always came easy to me. I'm not going to lie. I was always in, you know, honors classes. And I was one of those kids that before I was in honors, I was bad. Because it was like, she too smart for her own good.
Oh.
But I always got my work done. No matter what I've done in school, I've always had good grades. That's very important to me. You know, school first.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Definitely think that. Mm-hmm. When we go into a big business meeting, we don't know what they're talking about. It's good to like educate yourself on vocabulary, mm-hmm. what things mean, financial, mm-hmm. you know, it's good to know about all that stuff. They take advantage of black girls, you know,
they
you
do.
Look pretty,
yeah.
They think you're automatically
think
dumb.
Yeah,
no, baby, I know what you're talking about.
I know what that means.
I can own your business in 2.7 seconds.
In 2.7 seconds.
Do you think you, from Jaida now to Jaida in high school, do you think there was a big change?
Oh, definitely.
What
Lord.
Has changed about her?
She's way more, let's say, understanding.
Mm-hmm.
Understanding of life, understanding of her own feelings, understanding of the world around her. I wasn't like a self-centered person, but I was more so like a why person. Whenever anything would happen, I would always want to know the why, you know, even if it was to the point where it wasn't good for me.
Yeah.
So I think I'm learning to just, the difference between high school and Jaida now is Jaida now understands life is just life. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And you can't hold on. You can't be angry. You can't be overly sad when you know sometimes things are out of your control. I used to be very controlling back in high school with my life, with everything around me. I wanted to be in charge.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to have it the way I wanted or my world was over. Now as an adult, I'm realizing, good luck if that's your
yeah.
mentality. Good luck.
You can't control everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, that I think I see that as me growing up. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes a bad moment does not make a bad day. It's
at
really
all.
Just how you go about your day after that event. How do you deal with your emotions? Because we are women, we're emotional creatures.
Mm-hmm.
So like when we have a bad moment, it might make us feel like, oh, this is just a bad day. How do you deal with like bad days?
Because
on social media, baby, she's a baddie 24/7.
I don't have no bad
days. You don't have no bad days. But in real life, is that
okay, I'll give you a perfect example. Last night, I had a terrible nightmare.
Mm-hmm.
It woke me up this morning. I was crying. Like,
you was crying?
Girl, I'm going to be real. I was crying when mm-hmm. I woke up this morning because I had a terrible nightmare. Because, you know, I mean, I dream, but when I do dream, it'd be nightmares sometimes.
Yeah.
Like, the ones that I can remember.
I have nightmares, too. That's why I'm
so,
watching
yeah.
them. I'm scared
no
movies.
Scary stuff.
No, I'm scared.
And my mindset when I woke up was just very like, ugh, you know, I didn't
mm-hmm.
want to do anything. Like, of course, I was going to still come, but I was
yeah.
just kind of like down, you know?
Yeah.
And I think what allows me to jump out of that bad mood is knowing that it's over. That moment is literally over.
Yeah.
That's like, I don't know if that works for some people, but for me, I literally have to tell myself, like, it's over. Like, you literally
your
cannot go back.
Extend what the fuck you feel,
exactly.
But, like,
the event happened in
over.
My dreams at 4 a.m. Now it's over.
Girl,
but
that's a word.
Yeah.
That's a word.
It's over.
It's over.
It's over.
It's over.
Like,
over.
What can you do? What can you do? You literally cannot even go back a few seconds. So what is the point in staying
in
that,
that
space
moment,
all
yeah.
day?
Yeah, that I can totally understand that, girl, because honestly, this morning, my little brother, I had to watch him, and my mama's like, my nail's done, you know what I'm saying? I'll be right back.
Yeah.
Girl, time is ticking.
where you at?
Where you at? And she's like, yeah, I'm on my way. I'm on my way. The time for me to leave, because I love to leave early.
Me
too. I have really bad anxiety. That's why I was like, she is on time. That's supposed to be me. I'm like, oh, my God. So, and then the Starbucks, because we need our drinks. Like,
yeah,
that
to.
Is essential to my videos. So, like, yeah, I can definitely understand having bad moments. I did too, but I'm
yeah.
glad that two queens,
both
we made it.
We did.
Talk about music. What made you get into music when you were younger? Like,
Lord, let my dad tell it. I've been humming myself to sleep since I was like 3 or 4.
Mm-hmm.
It started, I guess my dad always tells me, like, you know, back in the early 2000s. When Usher was hot.
Oh, Usher.
Hot, he always hot, but when he was really hot,
mm-hmm.
the Confessions and stuff came out. I'm sitting back there. My dad's I'm always like, Daddy, play Usher, play Usher.
Mm-hmm.
And it got to a point where my dad was realizing, like, oh, there's a voice in her. Like, it might be a little, you know, baby soft tone now, but she's trying to sing.
Listening to.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I started singing for the family. You know, my dad would be like, Nenny, because that's what we say in our language. You're like, Nenny, come here. Like, that's like baby. And I'd be like, what's up, dad? And he'd be like, I give you $20 if you sing. Like, my dad was really the one who made me show off my talent, even when I was nervous. So from a very young age, I had always sang in front of people. It went from just a few people on the block to us knocking on people's doors in Akron.
Y'all was knocking on people's doors?
You know, we knew the street. We
knew people. Okay, y'all knew the people.
You know, but it was just my dad's way of letting me get my butterflies out, you know? I used to sing at my dad's company parties when he was in the military, and then I started doing talent shows, and then when I got to high school, middle school, I was like, really, this is what I want to do. And I've been doing it ever since. Like, this has been my whole life. Like, I could literally go into keen detail of what I've done, but it's just been my whole life, honestly.
So, like, when did you start writing songs?
Freshman year.
Freshman
I realized
year.
I could write. Yeah.
Were you, like, I don't know if you were driving then, but, like, were you going? See, I
was driving.
I love music. I used to be that girl that would go type in karaoke.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I think every girl go on YouTube and karaoke, because it's something about singing. Okay, Janelle, I'm looking at karaoke.
Trigger.
So, like, when did you just be like, stop the karaoke, let me make my own songs? Like, so freshman year?
Yeah, I realized I could write, and I just... That was when I started looking for beats, like, and just little stuff on YouTube. And I just started trying to write. At first, my songs were kind of, you know, a little all over the place. But then I realized, like, I can really do this. Because I've always loved English. I've always been the one who likes essays, who likes the creative writing, you know, little
me
prompts,
too, girl.
Poems, all of that. I was a reader, so it came naturally for me. I just, like, really had to give myself the freedom to think and not want it to be perfect. And
just let it naturally flow. Okay, so, like... When did you take it serious when you found a song that, okay, you know how, because I used to write music too, and it would just be like, oh my God, this song right here.
Yeah.
Like, when did you find that song that made you want to be like, I got to go to the recording studio? Like, you know what I'm saying?
It's this song that I wrote called On My Mind. I've still never recorded it. Like, it's, and I think it's still one of my best songs, but it was definitely one of those songs. I think for me, I have to really connect with the song. Like, it has to be emotion. Because I'm such a writer that I sometimes write stuff that I want to maybe sell to G Herbo one day. Like, I write just to write sometimes. But it definitely has to be something. I like the beat and I like what I'm talking about. Like, I'm a person of substance. I'm not ever going to give the world just a bunch of BS. I'm not. I can't force myself to do that. That's not me. So it has to be definitely something I feel like represents my sound and who I am very well. It's always random. Like, I never am just putting out rap. I'm never just putting out singing. Sometimes it's a blend of both. Sometimes it's a completely different genre than what I just gave you. It's just something that I guess I have to say I just have to be able to connect with.
And I feel like you as an artist, you're the type of person that is like, it's about the art.
Yes.
Don't want to be put in a creative box. Like, that's what the labels, they
don't
see
want
the
brand.
Thing that pops out, and then they say, okay, this is what I want you to do. And it feels like you're going to be the one that's be like, no, I want to try this. I want to do this. And I do hear in your song, like, Casanova, it gives you more of, like, the instruments.
Yeah.
They're different. It's not like something that we would hear from here. So, I definitely, the versatility queen, for sure, for sure. And then I've heard one of your songs where it's like rap and it's got that trap beat, like you want to switch it up.
I
so
do.
I definitely see that. When did you start rapping?
I started rapping in high school. I can't lie about that one. I didn't always rap. Singing was definitely what I knew I could do. Freshman year is when I really started. And it started at Southside. People used to just be beating on the tables, having little rap battles, you know? And I used to try to jump in. I used to try to, or I'd be in my head, like, listening, like, oh, Or you remember that, like, challenge in middle school? Was like, That's
where
it started, like, at the little table, just when people make beats. I was trying to rap quietly in my head. And then one day I did a cover, freestyle to, you know, that song that's like Gucci Gang, Gucci Gang, Gucci Gang by Lil Pump or something like that. Like, I made a little song
remix
to it. And then I realized I could rap. And I was like, oh, yeah, I kind of like this. This is when I'm feeling a little cocky. Like, I'm feeling a little, let's get it, you know?
Were you the type of person when you made, like, songs that just made you be like, oh, this shit really, you know what I'm saying? Did you show it to your friends?
I'm very, very picky about that. That's the one thing. I don't even show my music to all my family. I'll put it that way. Yeah. I'm a very sacred person because I feel like, in a way, I don't want to show somebody something and then I don't get the reaction that I thought I was.
Definitely or, can feel you on that.
Or I feel like I lost that specialness about it. You know, like, I haven't sat on it long enough. I really don't show people my music till it's released. Mm-hmm. You know, because then at that point, there's no more expectations on my end.
It's out.
And I feel like sometimes it can take away the specialness of the song.
So if you show you keep it, to yourself until you feel like you're ready to
share.
Okay. Because, I could definitely relate to, like, even with my YouTube videos, you know what I'm saying?
Can't
like,
show everybody.
You show it to them, they'd be like, oh, okay. You want them like, oh my goodness. Like, that could really, and that is a good valuable lesson, like, to not give your happiness or rely your happiness on other people. If somebody don't just give you the, you know what I'm saying, I'm supposed to still be like, well, I know.
I love it.
Yeah, I know I what I get. How do you feel about, like, your support group? Like, do you have a good support group?
Oh, definitely.
You do?
It's very, very small. Like, of course, I have what I call, I don't like to say fans. I call them my loves because I love everybody that loves my music and loves me. But my support system is definitely my family and my boyfriend. Like, and that's, as far as tight-knit, that's my people, you know? Like,
that's how, the smaller the circle, too much people got too much stuff. They put it in negative energy and, like, your relationship. How did y'all meet?
Me and Mac? Yes. Oh, Lord. We met in high school, girl. Back in the day, summer 16-ish time frame. But we've been knowing each other for some years. But, like, really started to mess around, I would say, like, my sophomore year when I was at Greenville High. Uh-huh. So
that's where it carried on to when y'all... y'all was friends.
We were friends.
Started off as close friends. Yes, okay. Girl, you ain't even got to explain because everybody done had their
little... They had their little...
You know what I'm saying? But y'all stuck. Yeah. That's the thing.
Yeah, that's my boo.
Been there, done that. But mine didn't stick. Okay, so, like, fashion. Where do you think you get your fashion inspiration from?
My style of clothing is I like to show off my body. I'm not even going to lie. Whether it's in some jeans, sweatpants, I like to show my figure. That's very important for me. I like clothes that fit. I'm not one of those girls who I feel like would rock the big baggy clothes look. It's dope, but that's just not me. So I really think when I talk about style, I always look at the early 2000s. Like when it, I just like the tightness of everything, the jeans, the crop tops. But like people specifically, like Selena Quintanilla, like if y'all go back and look at some of her fit pics, sis was fresh. Aaliyah, younger Beyonce, who else? And then a lot of these influencers on Instagram, like just the way they put their stuff together, you know, like I don't know, I kind of like pick apart like different things I see people wear, and I like, I might not like that specific shirt, but I like the way it fits you. I think that'll fit me good. Like that's kind of how I do it. Like I don't know, I'm kind of random. It's really whatever I'm feeling.
It's whatever you're feeling. You just go in your closet and be like,
I'll put that on today.
So like, I know you had started a fashion line or whatever. What do you want to, like, where do you see you going? Like, is it just swimwear? Because I know right now it's swimwear. Do you want to make it broader?
So with Alarentic, that is my clothing brand. It's just getting started. It's not really off the ground yet. I was kind of doing some test drops, you know what I mean? Seeing if people would actually want to buy it, things like that. For right now, it's going to be swimwear, but I do plan on making it more broad, like, you know, tops, bottoms and stuff like that. But right now I'm kind of focused on music, so I don't want to overcommit.
Do you like performing?
Yes. I really love it.
What do you like about the performing?
Skill level it takes to truly connect with the audience, because anybody can get up on stage with a microphone and be great, but if the audience doesn't feel you, if you don't know how to move that crowd, every crowd isn't the same. You know, you can't just walk into a building, even as a rapper, and just start da-da-da-da-da. People gonna be like, okay, cool. But I like to try to interact with people. I like to gauge the audience first. So for me, that's a skill, because I want to be a real performer. When I think of performing, I think of Michael Jackson, Beyonce, Bruno Mars, like Tina Turner. Like I'm giving you life.
Yeah,
like I'm
giving you. Just, exactly. It's a show.
It's a show. And that's concert. What I've been working on. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you, I went to a Nicki Minaj concert when I was 16. And Nicki, I feel like she feels the same way, because, like, it was a show. Like, you know, it's a show when Nicki had songs that I didn't even know about.
Yeah.
That I was like, oh my God, when I go home, I got to look at that, because she performed it so well. What do you like to do in your free time?
In my free time, like in the summertime, since that's the relevant time right now, I like to lay out in the sun. I like to play with my dogs. Like, I love being in nature. So I love working out. Mm-hmm. I love walking with them. And I love just, like, doing my makeup. Yeah. And, like, you know, being a girl. And getting all girly. And I really, really love to sing. Like, karaoke. Back to that. Girl, I would spend hours on some karaoke.
I would spend hours. Okay. I'll be begging my friends. Can we please go to a karaoke bar? Because I just want to go to a karaoke. I just want to go to a karaoke bar. It seems like my heart. Let's be drunk. Just singing. I just sound. Yeah, I'm a karaoke person.
And another thing I like to do is I like to write. I'm working on a book. Like a little mystery.
It just never ends with you, though. Like, no, for real, no. She does fit. Let's just calculate it, y'all. Let's just calculate it together. She does fitness, okay? I know you can cook because I didn't see it on Snapchat. She does her hair. Okay, so I seen her a couple times, and it's like a different style every time. You do makeup.
I do.
You do fashion. You sing, dance, art. Do you do art?
I can paint, yeah.
You can paint. Like, what can you not do? Like, what? I know Matt is like, I am so lucky because you switch it up. You're a different girl every day just doing that. That is crazy. That is crazy. You're a born, like, mogul star.
Thank
like,
you.
I can't wait to see, like, your journey continue and flourish. So is anything else you want to talk about?
No. Well, I'm just grateful that you had me on your channel.
Did you enjoy it?
I did. I feel like this was my first interview where you took the time to, like, really get to know me.
Yeah.
You came prepared, all of that. Like, it was a great experience.
Thank you. Oh, my God. And, y'all, this girl, everybody that I have met and interviewed, everybody has been so humble and nice, and I'm just really blessed. So, I'm going to see you guys in the next interview, and I want to thank you again for just coming, for real, and taking the time out and being amazing and beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you. So, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.
Bye.